Hi everybody, I'm Sarah Ockwell-Smith. Welcome to my latest SOS parenting video. Today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about babies, toddlers and preschoolers who wake up either in the morning or more usually after a nap very, very upset with lots of tears and uncontrollable crying and, you know, several minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes even, of being really, really, really upset and not calming down once they wake. So there are a couple of reasons that this could happen. If we're talking babies, so by babies I mean under 12 months of age, what's likely to be the cause there, particularly if they're sort of between 7 and 12 months old, is separation anxiety. So they've woken up, and especially if you're not there, especially if they're in a different room and they wake up and you're not there, there's a kind of like an absolute terror when they wake up and they think, oh my goodness, where's my mum? Where's my dad? Where's my carer? They were with me and now they're not. And have they gone? Have they abandoned me forever? And it's just the sort of terror and grief of where have you gone? Sometimes there can be a bit of separation anxiety, even if you're laying right next to them, because temporarily when they wake up, they don't remember where they are and they don't remember where you are. And that can be a little bit scary, but less so than if they wake on their own. What tends to happen with older children, so by older children I would say toddlers and preschoolers, and particularly after a nap, less so at night, but it can happen when they wake first thing in the morning, is something called a confusional arousal disorder. So sleep is basically a series of electrical states that the brain goes through, with the sort of electrical impulses firing all the way through the brain. Some children, and actually lots of adults as well, not lots, some adults as well, will wake up effectively too quickly. So what happens when we wake up normally is that we go through different stages of sleep that gets lighter and lighter and lighter, and the electrical impulses change, and we wake up nice and slowly. So when we wake up, we within a few seconds of opening our eyes, we know where we are, we know we've been asleep, we know what time it is, we're aware fully of our surroundings. We know we've been asleep and we know we're now awake. For some older babies, toddlers, preschoolers and adults, they wake up too quickly. So they've been in a deep sleep state and they've been suddenly kind of pulled out of it. And they've just woken up and not gone through all of those nice stages, and the electrical impulses are sort of misfiring a little bit, and then they wake up and it's very much, where am I? Am I still asleep? Am I still awake? Am I dreaming? And what room am I in? Who am I? Where am I? It's basically, they don't know that they're awake fully. It's incredibly confusing and really, really disorientating. So they just have no idea of their surroundings or who they are or where they are or anything. And it's really, really scary for them. So what you tend to find happens is they wake up and they're incredibly upset. There'll be lots and lots of tears, and sometimes they can seem quite angry, but just very, very disorientated. So they'll sort of look at you, their eyes will be quite glassy, and have sort of like rather than fixing on your eyes and really seeing you're there, they sort of have like a faraway gaze and glazed eyes, and they really will seem as if they're almost trapped in a dream a little bit, and it will be incredibly, incredibly hard to calm them down. So you might try talking to them, you might try cuddling them, all of the things that you would ordinarily do to calm them down, and it just doesn't work. And sadly, the only thing that you can really do with confusional arousals is to understand them and give them time. They will pass naturally as the child grows. But until they do, sadly, the best thing that you can do, I think, is just to understand them and keep the child safe. Take lots of deep breaths and just wait for it to pass. But know that it is it is normal. You know what's happening and it will pass. But I hope that's helped to understand them, even if it doesn't help you to solve them. Thanks for tuning in. Bye.